会关我。你不信得的我啊？你不信得我有病，我有病关吗？
倫敦眼咯，因為倫敦眼啦，英國嘅地標之一咯。
Speak English. Speak English.
This is one of the London icon called London Eyes.
哈哈哈哈哈。哈
哈哈，
嗰个
食饭，
啊
嗰个位，
系啊。个个都中意呢个位啊，吓，个个中意呢个位啊。啊，边个霸住呢个位先？
Stay on the mic. Well, that's not a problem at all. Now, I do have to stress, ladies and gents, myself and the captain, we are not professional tour guides by any means. We are simply your crew. So if we get anything wrong, well, feel free to keep it to yourself. I'm only joking. And I do also understand, not everybody speaks their English language. So I will speak a little bit slower, clearer, so our American friends can join in as well. Is everybody happy? Fantastic. We love the Americans. So we'll start off on the right-hand side. You cannot miss it. It's London's biggest attraction. It's the fifth biggest observation well in the world. It's the London Eye. Now, the London Eye was put here in London in the year 2000 by British Airways. And it was only meant to be here for a couple of years. But due to its financial success, the London Eye is now here to stay. On a clear sunny day, in the height of our peak season, that well makes a quarter of £1 million a day. That's £17,000 on one single rotation. Now, people in London, they have been petitioning for its name to be changed. to the wheel of fortune. Now the next bridge, or the first bridge on your trip today, is Charing Cross Bridge and the Jubilee footpath. Is it yours? Well, madam.
I didn't see where it came from.
This is called Charing Cross and the Jubilee footpath. How many passengers on the top? We do encourage you wait. There is a reason for this. To keep those fans waiting for us. It keeps their hands occupied. It stops them from throwing stuff at you. I had a kebab for a couple last week. It was unpleasant. Now if you got a kebab, it just means they're on holiday. If they didn't wave back, I am very sorry. It just means they're from London. Now on the right-hand side, we have the Royal Festival Hall. Now many of the greats over the years, they have performed at the Royal Festival Hall, such as Pavarotti, Frank Sinatra, Michael Jackson, Whitney Houston, even Amy Winehouse. The list goes on. Sadly, they all have one thing in common. They're no longer with us today. So we're just waiting now for the Justin Bieber concert. Is it? I'm sorry. I'm only joking. And on the left-hand side, the stone obelisk. That's called Cleopatra's Needle. Probably the oldest thing you will see in London today. It's 3,500 years old. It's older than London itself. It was given to this country by a very thankful Egyptian government for Lord Nelson's bravery in the Battle of Nile. Now the next bridge is called Waterloo Bridge, also known as the Ladies' Bridge. Because during the war, when the men were away fighting, a 90% female workforce built this bridge. It was the only bridge in London to be built on time, under budget. So well done to the ladies. And on the left-hand side, after trees, the stone building with the green dome and the Union flag. This is called Somerset House. Now, this house was once home to all of the certificates. The birth, the marriage, and the death certificates. It's where it got its nickname, the Hatcham, the Matcham, and the Dispatcham. But now the Taxman has moved in, so we have added the Catchem. It's a lovely place to visit in the month of December. They have lots of Christmas markets and a huge ice rink for the children. Well worth a visit. Now over to the left-hand side, you're surely going to see a white with a yellow funnel. This is the HQS Wellington. She was an old New Zealand warship many years ago, but she's now the only floating livery hall in existence. Now if you don't know what that means, it's basically a floating pub for retired sea captains. Now to be a part of that prestigious club, you'd had to have served at sea as a master mariner for 20 years. Now if you look to the back of the ship, which is the stern of the ship, in a few moments you are going to see an archway with a picture of old Father Thames on top. This is a boundary marker. You are now leaving the city of Westminster and you are now entering the 1 square mile city of London. And over to your right hand side, one of the finest beaches in Europe, Costa del London, also referred to as the London Riviera. Has anybody seen Baywatch? That is not where they filmed Baywatch, folks. Normally you see kids playing with the broken glass and the dogs drinking the polluted Thames water. It's well worth a visit, just don't forget your sunscreen. But staying on the right, the red brick building with the tower that says OXO. This is the famous Oxo Tower, or better known as Mum's Graven. Now, it's completely forbidden to advertise on the banks of the Thames. This is why you don't see billboards or McDonald's signs, because it's completely illegal. So Oxo was taken to court. They said it was a complete coincidence how their brand ended up in those windows. Now they won their court case, and they've had nearly 70 years of free advertising here on the River Thames. But it's now home to one of the best restaurants in London, at the very top, the Harvey Nichols restaurant. And just underneath, well, some affordable luxury apartments. Now we're surely going to be going under the Blackfriars Bridges. The first bridge you see is the Blackfriars Road Bridge, opened by Queen Victoria, and the architect was John Cubitt. He was also the architect for the Western Railway Services and Weymouth Inn in Dorset. So this bridge marks the halfway mark on our trip from Westminster to Tower. Is everybody happy? Is everybody enjoying the live commentary?
Yes!
Oh, fantastic. Now as we go underneath the Blackfriars Road Bridge, you will see another bridge very close. This is the Blackfriars Railway Bridge. Now you may remember this one from a film called Mission Impossible, when Tom Cruise ran across the top. That's the longest solar panel bridge in Europe. It gets 50% of its power from its roof for the station underneath. Once we go underneath this bridge, if you look back up to the very top, you can see people waiting for their train. Now they're trained there, but they're still waiting for their train. It's a platform bridge. It cost £100 million to construct that bridge. Now over to the left-hand side, one of my favourite buildings here in London, Sir Christopher Wren's masterpiece, St Paul's Cathedral. Now many important people here in England, they have had their funerals over at St Paul's, such as Winston Churchill, Margaret Thatcher, and of course himself, Sir Christopher Wren. But it's a London architect's nightmare, because it's forbidden to cast a shadow over that building. This is why you don't see any high-rise buildings around St Paul's. Now here's one for the kids. The red brick building just in front of St Paul's. This is the City of London School. This is where Daniel Radcliffe went to school. Harry Potter. Now it will cost mummy or daddy £60,000 a year to send your child to the City of London. And for that kind of money, I would want my child to walk out with magical powers as well. Now on the right-hand side, the Circle White building with the timber frame and the thatched roof. This is the replica of Shakespeare's Globe. Now it's one of the only thatched roofs you will see here in London. Because after the Great Fire of London, all thatched roofs are now banned. Now you can see a play over here, guys, on certain days or evenings, in its periodic fashion. That's no electronics, no lighting, no toilets. It's like stepping foot back in time, for as low as £5. Now that's not bad value for money here in London. Considering a pint of beer will set you back around £6 plus. Now many years ago, there used to be an office on that site, and people used to put money into boxes and they took it to the office. We believe in London, it's where the term box office originates from. Now the next bridge is the Southwark Road Bridge. This is the most underused bridge here in London. And the reason for that, there is a one-way system to this bridge. Nobody knows where it is. So if you see anybody up there, please give them a smile and a wave, because I guarantee you they are lost. Hi there. Hi there, sir. Madam, you need to go this way. This way. A lot of the workers and the emergency services, they use this bridge because it's the least congested. Now, a lot of people ask me out here on the River Thames, what happens to London's rubbish? On the left-hand side, you can see a barge with some grey containers. This is called Warbrook Wharf. Now, 90% of London's rubbish leaves this site by barge, and we send it to a place called Essex. Now, they do get their own bag. They send it back to us via television. Has anybody seen that TV program, Tally? Well, if you have, I am very sorry. That's how they get their own bag. We're now going under Pennant Street Railway Bridge. Not a very interesting bridge. It does its job. It stops trains from falling in the rivers. But what is interesting, on the right-hand side, you are going to see an old pirate ship. Now we have a quick show of hands. Who likes Pirates of the... Well, if you're a fan, you may want to get a picture of this pirate ship. It's got absolutely nothing to do with the films. It's Sir Francis Drake's replica of the Golden Hind. Sir Francis Drake was the first Englishman to circumnavigate the globe. And the replica in the dock over there has done it twice. Now we're surely going to be going under the world famous London Bridge. Now people come from all around the world to see London Bridge. And guess what, ladies and gents? It's your lucky day, because this is what you get. They mistake this bridge for Tower Bridge, but London Bridge is the famous bridge. It's where the history lies. There has been London bridges on this site. The first one was built by the Romans over 2,000 years ago, and it was made out of wood. The last London Bridge was taken down, stone by stone, and it was sold to an American businessman, Mr. McCullough, and it now stands in Arizona. On the right-hand side, you cannot miss it. It's Western Europe's tallest building, the Shard, or better known as the Shard of Glass. Now, the Shard stands at over 1,000 feet tall, and it's home to the five-star Shangri-La Hotel. Now, you can go up the Shard. On the 72nd floor, they have a viewing platform. Now, the last time I checked, it was around £25. And on a clear sunny day, not like today, you can see up to 50 miles in any given direction. Now, the architect of the shop, he was an Italian man by the name of Renzo Piano. Now, if you're in London on a budget, look over to the left-hand side. The building that looks like a walkie-talkie. This is called 20 Fenchurch Street. Now, at the very top of this building, as you can see, they have a viewing platform of their own. It's called the Sky Garden. Now, a lot of our passengers don't know this, but it's completely free of charge. It's all you need to do is book the Sky Garden before you arrive. I imagine the views are very similar to the shop. Now over to the right-hand side, on the front of the warship, you are now looking at the only Union Jack flag here in London. Now to be called a Union Jack, it must be on the front of a British warship, and it must be on a wooden jackstone. So all of the other flags you've seen today, or will see throughout the day. They are called Union. And the ship itself is the HMS Belfast. It was launched in Belfast on St. Patrick's Day in 1938 in the Harlem and Wharf shipyard. That was the same shipyard that built the ill-fated Titanic. Now the Belfast was one of the first British ships to fire its guns in anger on D-Day. And it last saw action in the Korean campaign. But it's now permanently moored here at London Bridge. It's a floating museum. It's a fantastic day out for the children. You can pay a small fee and explore all nine decks. Now what the captain likes to do here, folks, rather than just going straight into Tower Pier, we like to take our passengers up to Tower Bridge. And we like to turn this boat directly in front of Tower. And so you guys can get the best possible photo of the bridge itself. So in a couple of minutes, the boat will then turn, and on the right-hand side, there'll be a fantastic photo of the bridge itself. But in the meantime, look over to the left-hand side, the Tower of London. Now the Tower of London is nearly 1,000 years old. It was founded by William the Conqueror, and it's absolutely steeped in English history. It's been a prison, it's been a palace, it's been a place of execution. It's been an observatory, a royal mint, and it's even been a royal zoo. But it's now home to the crown jewels. Now many years ago, if you were found guilty up at Westminster, you would have been rowed down here to the Tower by a Thames waterman, but without a live commentary. And you would have gone through the tunnel on the left, where it says entry to the traitor's gate, and you would have had your head removed, dipped in tar, and placed on a spike above London Bridge. And that would be to warn all other traitors. But we now have far bigger punishments here in London. We have something called community service. So there we are, folks, as promised, a fantastic photo opportunity of Tower Bridge. Now, Tower Bridge is the gateway into London. It's 127 years old. It's a part bascule, part suspension bridge. The bascules are the centre parts of Tower Bridge, and they will only ever be fully raised when a member of the royal family is going underneath. Now they say, ladies and gents, if you can get a picture of a red double-decker bus in the middle of Tower Bridge, well, that's too iconic of London. That will cost you £5 on a postcard. Now, if the bus is stuck in traffic, well, that's three iconic sights of London. Now, lots of people don't know this. Please take your children. I was left on this boat when I was 4 years old, and nobody came back for me to stay with mummy and daddy, kids. And for the parents, don't just take the good kids. Take those naughty ones as well. We're going to be alongside Tower Pier for about 10 minutes. And then we're going to turn this boat around and proceed east towards Greenwich. So if your ticket says Greenwich, please do stay on the boat. But if you would like to go back to Westminster or the London Eye for Waterloo, disembark here, boarding point B. That's B for back, or B for Big Ben. And if your ticket says, this is also your stop. Go to the top of the hill, do a right, and your bus will be waiting for you. And lastly, a few words regarding the live commentary. As I said at the beginning of your trip, we are not professional tour guides. You probably all figured that one out yourself. We are crew members on board this boat, and our job is solely to keep you guys safe. But sadly, the company doesn't provide a live tour guide. So the reason we do this on Albert, as crew members, on a voluntary basis, is because we get much better feedback from our passengers. An old tradition out here on the River Thames that dates back generations. If you've learned something today, or you've enjoyed the few words I've said downriver, and you would like to show a token of your appreciation, we have the silver champagne captain's tip bottle. It'll be tied off downstairs as you leave, and it's completely voluntary, as was the live commentary. Now, if you're wondering what happens to this money, well, it's very simple. It goes to the all-important research. The research myself and the captain will be conducting this evening around about 7 p.m. in a place we like to call the pub. Ladies and gents, thank you so much for your kind attention. My name is Alfie. Have a lovely day here at the tower and stay safe. Thank you.